Welcome to my new walk-in closet. Thought I would show you guys how I organized and set everything up. When I was moving everything in, I also decided to really edit down my closet. I got rid of 6 massive bags and donated them. Needed to do this cleanse on my closet because not only were there pieces that I just hadn't worn, there were also pieces that I just didn't fit in anymore. That sounds so LA. I gave my closet a cleanse. I'm so LA that even my closet does a cleanse. Really though, in the last year, I have changed shapes. Went from being a pencil for 25 years of my life to like having this womanly figure. It was literally like I woke up and my body was like, happy birthday, have a child. I had pieces and like shorts that I have blocked and worn and loved. And now I'm like, how did I get a leg in here? I don't understand. Take me back. Now that we've just experienced puberty with Carly, I feel like this is a great time to get into the actual closet organization. I did good on the organizing, guys. Laps for me. I would show you guys how I actually organized everything from the clothes to the accessories. So hopefully this video could inspire you guys if you are looking to clean out your closets. If your body also decided to gift you with a set of hips for your birthday this year, maybe this video can help you guys.
So this is my walk-in closet, and this unit is actually from IKEA. This is the pack system, and you can design your own closet basically with this system. I have 4 separate units, so on the outside is a smaller one, the center are 2 larger ones, and then the outside is another smaller one. On the outside units, I have the shelving built into it, and I picked these out from IKEA. They're like rolling shelves, and they're like the clear glass front, so you could see what's inside of them. The center storage units are actually from the Container Store, and I bought these long before I had a walk-in closet. I kept these in my closet in my old place in Chicago, and these are really great because you can also pick out the color of the top, you can pick out what the drawers look like, you can pick out the size of the drawers, you can pick out how many drawers you want. So if you're looking for a less expensive option, these units from the Container Store are really, really helpful for organizing a smaller space. So I have my clothes color-coded in my closet. Can you tell that I like neutrals? But within the color coding, I also have them coded according to like type of style. So I have tops and dresses all in this one section, and in my old place I actually had my tops and my dresses separate, so now I've consolidated my clothing and put everything into this one space. I have it set up from like more casual like dresses to more formal dresses, all within their color. So I have it started with black over on the left unit, and I have the dresses ranging from like fully solid black dresses and going into prints and more textures. So it's like black and gray, black and white, anything that's like striped or printed goes in that section. I start with dark gray in the next closet unit and work that into gray with prints, and then lighter gray with texture, and then I move into sequins, and this is where I keep all of my like fully embellished pieces like dresses and skirts. And then it goes into white, white with patterns, and then I have my clothes arranged from cream into like muted pinks and beiges, and then fully ending in the colored section. This middle section where there's a little bit of color showing through is because that's where I keep my maxi dresses, because there's that longer opening. And then in front of my maxi dresses is where I keep my overnight bags or my carry-on bags. These are just larger bags. If color coding seems to be too much of a task for you, if it kind of scares you and you're like, whoa, that takes so much work and I'm not a very organized person, I can't do that. Trust me, girl, I'm the same way as you. And actually color coding helps keep me organized because I know exactly where things are, and it's easier for me when I'm getting ready to just be able to go exactly where something is. So it actually ends up taking you less time every day when you have your closet. It just takes a little bit in the beginning to get it color coded, but then once it is, you actually end up saving a ton of time. So in this first section of shelving is where I keep my purses, and in the first drawer is kind of my everyday bags. I have one of my wallets, and I have a crossbody, and then I have my more like throw everything in kind of bags. And the second drawer is where I have kind of my more like upscale glamorous purses. So I have my sparkly Chanel, I have my kaleidoscope purse that I got as a gift for my birthday, and then I have my black patent leather purse with a bow on it. My third drawer is where I keep more of my more like stylized purses, because I have a pink purse in here. In the fourth drawer, I have more like stylized kind of bags. I have a metallic camera bag, I have a leather camera bag, and then I also have my style haul bag. Shout out to my second family, I love you guys, and obviously I'm representing you guys in my closet. In the first drawer of these mesh containers is where I keep my one piece swimsuits, and then in my second drawer is where I keep my bikini style swimsuits, and I have these arranged by more like shape swimsuit tops and flat bikini tops. I have the bottoms also arranged by color and print, and then I have my triangle bikini tops because they're neoprene, kind of folded in the center because those don't lay as well. My third drawer is where I keep all of my hats. So I have beanie hats in one section, and then I have more stylized hats like my sequin beret. The drawer in the bottom is where I keep all of my gloves and my arm warmers. In the top drawer of the larger mesh unit is where I keep my oversized hats. In the second drawer is where I keep some of my everyday scarves. These are scarves that I wear really frequently, so I have my black blanket scarf and then some of my printed scarves. In the third drawer is where I keep other scarves that I don't wear as much, so I have a bunch of bigger, thicker snoods. And the last drawer is where I keep all of my like clutches and wallets and smaller purse type accessories. The first drawer in this set of shelving is where I keep my athletic wear, so I have my sports bras in the top section here. And the second drawer is where I keep my workout pants, and I have these arranged by either like plain workout pants and then workout shorts as well as SoulCycle workout pants. In the third drawer is where I keep my gym shoes, so I just have three pairs of gym shoes in here, and then under that is where I keep my flats and my sandals. So the top shelf in this unit is where I keep my more like sequin slash fashion-y type bottoms. So I have sequin shorts, sequin pants, and then I have my palazzo pants, which are kind of like the oversized high-waisted pants. The second drawer is where I keep my more regular shorts. So I have like my white shorts, my basic shorts, my high-waisted shorts, and then the center is where I keep my more skort type of shorts. In the third drawer is where I keep leggings. So I have like them split apart by basic black leggings, stretchy pants, and then also Lululemon leggings. And the last drawer is where I keep all my pants, and I also have these color-coded from regular blue denim to printed denim, and then I also have them in the bottom organized from color. So it's black jeans, neutral jeans, and then white jeans.
All right, guys, that is it for my updated closet storage and organization. I really encourage you guys, when you're looking at your closet, to just get rid of it. It's almost like a horcrux because you're like screaming at yourself and being like, no, don't do it. But then once you finally like bite the bullet and just get rid of it, you feel so relieved. Harry Potter jokes. What's up? I hope this video helped you guys get inspired to organize your closets, maybe. I'll see you next time. Bye. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know down below in the comments what your favorite part of this video was. Also, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you'll get notified every time I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.